All right, so I've managed to reboot since the last video, folks, and I haven't even launched anything yet in the operating system aside from my screen capture recorder, obviously. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to actually go right to the command prompt, and then I'm going to do the same thing that we did just before the last video ended, and that is I'm going to type in Ruby dash V, and I'm crossing my fingers. Okay, so for Nathan, for you, it worked. The reboot brought it in. Richard, you didn't have that issue at all, but I did. But I was the one that had the pre-existing version. Okay, so yeah, you're fresh install, so no problems. But you still had to reboot to get the path. And for me, obviously, that's not the case. So what I need to do is I need to go back to our core shell. So you guys, bear with me here while I bring up Chrome. And I'll get into the core shell. And then I'll walk you through the process in case you're in the same boat as me of making sure that the path statement is included. One way that you could do it is you could uninstall everything and reinstall it, right? I think that would be a little bit cumbersome, you know? It's kind of like, you know, scrapping a car for a flat tire.